I just replaced Spotlight. I don't have Spotlight on my machine. I think I actually also disabled the process on like a root level. I mean, there's no point to using Spotlight if you use Raycast, right? Like it does everything but better.
I'm really curious to know how you've been using Raycast with Cal.com. But for the ones who don't know what Cal.com is, do you want to just explain a little bit about what your product is?
We are providing scheduling infrastructure for everyone, which means we are an open source startup focusing on connecting people with calendar meetings to make appointments that work for both the host and the attendees. Nowadays, we work with anywhere from small yoga teachers to governments. It's been great to be working on this project. It's so much fun and so many different use cases. We've been quite fortunate to be working with a community member of the Raycast community to bring Cal.com to Raycast. And it's a very simple app. It's just, you know, share your meeting link. Basically, I just type in Cal and then I click enter and I get all my links that I'm using on a day-to-day basis. All I do is just click it and then I have it, right? And so if I paste it into my messenger, I can just send it over. I think I can even give a sneak preview that we're actually extending this app to include some fancy AI features as well. So the brief demo would be kind of like Cal and then book Pedro next week. And it would basically check out all the availabilities and promote a time that works for the both of us.
What other workflows do you do?
I am terrible with churning browsers. So what I did, I still have like my muscle memory for Chrome, right? So if I type in Chrome, it opens Arc. So what I did is I just gave Arc the alias. So if I go into my Raycast settings, and in Arc, I just gave it the Chrome alias. So every time my stupid brain wants to open Chrome, I open Arc. I love that feature. It's just, you know, kind of like hack your own brain.
Hack your own brain. I love that.
What I also do a lot is just the copy clipboard, right? So if you have a... I don't want to show it right now because I don't know what's in there.
Yeah, totally.
I mean, yeah, the clipboard history, I mean, just having a quick... you know, look of the past things that I've saved is just such a lifesaver.
Do you think there's anything that you do in Raycast that most people don't know about?
I'd say maybe, but like time in San Francisco or something, that's like super freaking dope. You know, I mean, as a remote company, I use this all the time, or just like what's like 25 euro in yen. It's just peace of mind where you expect something, and this is honestly most of the time better than the kind of like the native Siri thing that you have on your iPhone. I mean, some of the things you can do in Siri.
I think that surprise factor that you try something without knowing whether it's going to work or not, and it works, is just amazing.
Yeah.
You haven't mentioned any hotkeys. So is that something that you use a lot or not really?
I think the hotkeys that I use are just the ones that open Raycast and then I type whatever I use, right? Like that's kind of like, I've never really seen this to be faster to like do command shift something over like command space and then signal if I want to, like S for signal. Or I understand why people use hotkeys, but I think for me it's just easier to type whatever I need.
As you start searching for things in Raycast, it learns for the things you search the most, and it has like a weighting indexing algorithm. So if you type in AR and what you're looking for is Arc, after two or three times you do that, Arc is going to be the first on the list.
You know, fun story, back in the days before Raycast, there was Spotlight and I kept mistyping Chrome. Well, I didn't mistype it, but CH would open Chrome, but then I, for some reason, clicked chess too many times, and every time I put in CH, it would open the fucking chess app, right? And in Spotlight, you couldn't disable it. So in Raycast, like this just doesn't happen. Like the amount literally the amount of hours I've opened chess. And the thing with the chess app is, A, it loads super slow, but it blocks the entire machine. And then it asks for like an update or sign in to your game center or whatever. It took like 2 minutes to close the app. And I'm like, I don't want to open chess, right? So with Raycast.
And I don't think you can uninstall it, right? Because that's like a default app. At least you couldn't before.
I don't think you can uninstall it. Yeah, so it's great.
But you know what you can do? I'll show you a little trick now. Like if you never ever want to open chess, If you open up Raycast now and then press Command Shift Comma right now.
Command Shift Comma.
And you see that there's a little checkbox there at the end. So if you disable that, chess will never show up in your search anymore.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
So this is the kind of things that you can do within Raycast. You can be very granular with the search.
Very cool. Very cool. No more chess it is.
No more chess.
I want to shout out one more thing that I use every day is, and could you not, the color picker. It's so nice. Like if I have to, you know, pick a color. That used to be like a Chrome extension, right? Like I used to use like ColorZilla or somewhat. And the amount of just Chrome extensions I've removed just because it comes, you know, out of the box from Raycast is like...
I feel like it's these little things that sometimes they are the ones that save you the most amount of time. And you don't really need to be a crazy Mac power user to do this.
Correct.
You know?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Let's go back to the cow.com extension for a moment. Mm-hmm. It's very simple. Right, I remember reviewing that extension myself. And you just click one command that's available and you see all your meetings, you select the ones you want and it copies the URL.
Correct.
It's such a simple workflow, but if you do that a few times a day, you can start realizing how much time it will save you, right? Is there anything that you would change about Raycast? And if so, what would it be?
I'll make it default installed on every MacBook. I mean, Apple is a great company to be acquired by, I guess. Windows support. I have a Windows machine upstairs for like machine learning and stuff. And not having Raycast on the Windows is just something new. Like, why is this not working? Ah, shit, I remember I'm on a Windows.
Which extensions do you use the most? I think we all know the answer for that one.
It's actually not Cal. It's probably just... calculations, like calculator. I don't know if that counts. It's just, I mean, you build it. It's not a third party.
We can make it count. Let's make it count.
All right. If not, then it's the Arc one for sure.
Have you ever contributed to any extension? And if so, which one was it?
I did help out with the Cal extension. I have actually studied the Raycast open source project quite a lot because we've took some inspiration for our own app store from it.
Is there an extension that you wish existed but doesn't?
Do you have a Revolut extension?
Do we have a Revolut extension? I'm not sure. We have a Monzo one.
Okay. There's no Revolut extension. Here we go.
If you could only keep one Raycast extension out of everything we've talked about today, which one would it be?
Probably Clipboard. I mean, Clipboard alone can probably make $1 million a year in revenue just by if you sell it for $1 in the App Store, right? I mean, Clipboard history is great.
Cool, man. So that was great. I really enjoyed seeing how you use Raycast. It's great for people to see how you can just keep it simple and still benefit from being more productive. Any links you want to share? Any shout outs?
Shout out to my mom. She's also following me on Twitter. So if you want to be as cool as my mom, feel free to follow me if you want to get some stupid posts on your timeline.